Hello, I'm Dr. Karen with Embrace Life Ohm and Mother Core, and in our continuing series on light in your health, I am going to talk about the health impact of different choices for electric lighting. Now, the most dangerous electric lighting for your health is the fluorescent light bulb. To show you the first reason why fluorescent lights are bad for your health, we're going to do a demonstration with an AM radio set between the channels. So this is what the static sounds like with the radio by itself. Now listen to the change when I turn on the light bulb. The reason why you're hearing that sound is that the light bulb produces high levels of radio waves, also known as dirty electricity. Dirty electricity has been shown to influence neurotransmitter levels and may have other negative effects on your health. To show you the second reason why fluorescent lights are a problem, we're going to take some pictures through a manual spectroscope. Now, if you look at a picture we took of sunlight, you can see a nice full color spectrum. But the picture that we took of a fluorescent light, you can see is very spiky. This spikiness is because the fluorescent light is produced by sending energy through mercury gas. And so what you're seeing is the mercury gas emission spectrum. Now, not only is this very far from full spectrum lighting, but the mercury emission spectrum will actually energize any mercury that might be in your body and might cause mercury in your dental fillings or in your tattoos to move into your bloodstream. So the third reason why a fluorescent light is the problem is that the total amount of light produced and the total amount of blue light is enough to suppress your melatonin and offset your circadian rhythm at night. To measure the total brightness and the total blueness, we used a simple cheap light meter, about $15, and I used a dichroic blue filter on top of that meter to measure specifically the blue light. So to minimize the disruption of melatonin, we want to keep our total blue light at under 1 lux, and we want to keep our total light of all colors at under 50 lux, because it turns out that bright lights at other colors also disrupt the circadian rhythm and disrupt your ability to have a good night's sleep. So the standard fluorescent light has both too much blue and too much total brightness. So the next light bulb we're going to look at is a standard soft white LED. The LED still produces dirty electricity, but less than the fluorescent light. The standard soft white LED, though, is still too blue and too bright. So we also tested some LEDs that are marketed as helping you to get a good night's sleep. We found that these LEDs had lower blue light to total light ratios than the standard LED. However, the brighter LEDs, those that were over 400 lumens, were still bright enough to disrupt your circadian rhythm, and there was too much blue light escaping from the bulbs. The only specialty LED that passed our blueness and brightness test was the night-night SES LED. We had better luck when we tested retro LEDs, which were built to represent the original light bulbs made by Edison. The retro LEDs that were less than 2000K color temperature and less than 350 lumens in brightness passed our test. The traditional incandescent light is nice because it doesn't produce dirty electricity. And it has a full color spectrum that is actually similar to candlelight. Most incandescent lights, though, are still too blue and too bright. There are some incandescent lights that are better. For example, this 25 watt amber party light passed our brightness test, although it was a little bit too blue. The salt lamp, which is a small incandescent bulb covered with Himalayan crystal salt, was our absolute electrical winner. These lamps are low in dirty electricity, they have a good spectrum, and they're low in blueness and brightness. The only problem with incandescent lighting is that it does use more energy than the LED and fluorescent alternatives. So if you're going to use incandescent, we recommend keeping the total number of bulbs to an absolute minimum for your lighting needs. So in summary, the best electric lighting choice is a salt lamp. But if you need more light, you can use a dim amber-colored incandescent light or a dim LED with color temperature less than 2000K and lumens less than 350. And you're often going to find that as a retro LED or as a dim bug light. Thanks so much for watching.